So let's get started with your KIE.AI API key. So we use KIE.AI. There's a lot of different video and image and music AI models that you can access through the API on KIE.AI. KIE.AI is actually one of the cheapest that I've been able to find to be able to access Google's Veo3. And they've got Google Veo3 Fast, which is great for when you're testing video. So it's about 40 cents per 8-second video clip with audio. If you do find another one that is more cost effective than that, then please reach out and let me know. But to get started, you'll just need to sign up to an account. Just click on the get started, sign up. And once you're in it, another great thing about KIE.AI, there's no monthly subscription. You purchase credits. I really like that about the way that these platforms are doing that. They've also got a Discord community. And what you find when you go into your, once you've created an account, click on the profile picture at the top right, click on dashboard, and you've got a couple of options, either to top up with the credits or API key. Click top up with credits. We need some credits to get started. Very self-explanatory. Then head back over to the dashboard and then click API key and then create API key. You get a pop-up box. You just need to give your API key a name that you're going to remember. Click create. And just remember, these API keys, you need to treat them as though they're passwords. Keep them safe. If anyone manages to get hold of your API key, then they're going to be able to use your credits. Head over to n8n. And we connect to KIE.AI via an API request. And we do that with a HTTP node. You see we've got the little purple globe. And we see that on the node inside the workflow. We just double click on that, open it up. And what's happening, we're posting a request. And then we've got the URL that KIE.AI provides us. This is to access their VO model. And it will be generic credential type, header auth. And now we just click on here. We get a drop down saying create new credential. You can have a look at the documentation yourself. I'll give you what you need to put in just a sec. But just for your information, you can see you've got all of the different models that you can have access to. We're going on Veo3. It gives you this is where we get the URL from, and then the information that I'm about to give you. Once we've clicked in to create new credential, this box will come up. First thing to do, just give it a name so we know later on which one we're connecting to. And we need to type in authorization under this name section. That's authorization with a Z. If you've got a British keyboard, it might autocorrect. Mine does sometimes, and then actually change that back to an S. Something to look out for. And then in the value, like we can see in their API documentation, it says we've got bearer and then the token. That API token that they've given you, first you type the word bearer, then one space, and then paste that in. And this is just an example. If you want to be able to actually see it like this, there's, if you hover over your mouse, a little box will appear where it says fixed or expression. You can just click on expression if you want to see it like this, and then put that back to fixed. When you're running the workflow, if you have any problems with authorization, usually what happens is there's something wrong with this. What you can do, you can lock, if you come back into an AN, select that, click create new credential again, give it a name that you remember, so KIE.AI credential new or 1.1, and then just double check that you've got authorization and then bearer single space and that in their property. Great, there we are. That should be you set up with your KIE.AI credential.